Hello, this is Finkbig Online Education. Scenario 5 Mathematics for Combination, Unit 1, Trigonometric Formula, Equations and Inequalities. Lesson 1, Trigonometric Formula, Amutita Lewis. Unit 1, point 1 is the trigonometric formulas. Here we have principal formula of trigonometry, such as cosine of x plus y. Cosine of x plus y is equal to cosine of x times cosine of y, negative sine of x, sine of y, this one. Here you have negative sine. For the case of cosine, here you have negative cosine of x negative negative y is equal to cosine x times cosine y plus sine x, then sine y. Sine x plus y is equal to sine x. Here you have some permutation of x and y with respect to the case of cosine of x plus cosine of y, then plus cosine of x sine of y. Sine of x negative y is equal to sine of x cosine of y, negative cosine of x, then sine of y. You have the case of tangent. Tangent of x plus y is equal to tangent of x plus tangent of y over 1 negative tangent of x, then tangent of y. Tangent of x negative y, so the difference between tangent of x plus y and tangent of x negative 1 is some permutation of sine. Here we have plus, then here you have negative. Here you have negative, here you have plus. On the case of cotangent of x plus y and the cotangent of x negative y, it's inverse of this one. We inverse denominator to numerator. So the reason why we can write, as here you see, or write cotangent of x cotangent of y negative 1 or over cotangent of x of y plus cotangent of y. So cotangent of x negative y is equal to cotangent of x times cotangent of y plus 1 over cotangent of y negative cotangent of x. We have a point of addition and subtraction formula are useful when finding trigonometric numbers. You know trigonometric numbers. The value of trigonometric numbers such as sine, cosine, tangent, cotangent, and so on, of the angle. So we have example one. Use addition and subtraction formula to find the value of cosine of 75. So we have to divide 75 into two values. We can write cosine of, you have 45, then you add 30 degrees. So by using equation of addition of cosine of a plus b or cosine of x plus y can be applied on this case, or you can use another relation of subtraction. So you have example here, cosine of 75, you have to divide 75 into two relations. First one, 45 plus 30. By using a relation or formula of addition of cosine of x plus y, can be x will be replaced by 45 and y will be replaced by 30 in the formula. We get cosine of 45 times cosine of 30, negative sine of 45 times sine of 30. 45 and 30 are remarkable angles. Their values are known. Where 45, value of cosine of 45 is equal to square root of 2 over 2, then cosine of 30 is known also is square root of 3 over 2. As sine of 45 also is equal to square root of 2 over 2, and sine, the value of sine of theta also is known as remarkable angle is equal to 1 over 2. So finally, by making in a common denominator of 4, then square root of 2 times 3 is equal to square root of 6, then square root of 2 times square root of 1 is equal to square root of 2. This is the final answer of our simplification. Example, we have another example. Example 1.2. Use addition formula and the subtraction formula to find sine of pi over 12. You know this value of sine of pi over 12. Pi over 12 is 15 angles, 15 degree. Then 15 degrees by using this relation of addition or subtraction can be equal to 45 degrees negative 30 degrees. So by using this relation of course of sine of this one, sine of 45 negative 30, we'll somehow get the direct value of sine of pi over 12. As here you see, this is pi over 4 is equal to 45. Then pi over 6 is equal to 30. When you use this relation, sine of 45 is equal to square root of 2 over 2. Cosine of 30 is equal to square root of 3 over 2. Then negative square root of 2 over 2 times 1 over 2. Here we use relation of sine of x negative y. You know relation above. We have example 3. Use additional and subtraction formula to find this value. The value of 5 pi over 3. You know how to find this value. To find the degree corresponding to 5 pi over 3, you have to replace pi, its equivalent, replace the 2 degree. This is in radian, but in degree, replace it 180. Then make some division with 3, you get a value which is equal to, which is corresponding to this angle. So by using a tangent, a relation of a tangent, we can write this relation in subtraction form. 5 pi over 3 is like to write 2 pi negative pi over 3. When this one can be also transformed into this one by using some operations. By using relation of tan of x negative y, as you have seen it above, the result will be tan of 2 pi negative tan of pi over 3, then over 1 plus tan of 2 pi and tan of pi over 3. By using what is the value of 2 pi? The value of 2 pi, tan of 2 pi is equal to 0. The value of tan of pi over 3, you know, tan of 60, tan of 60 is equal to square root of 3. Then over, you have 1, tan of 2 pi is equal to 0. Even we multiply this value, which is equal to square root of 3, you will remain with 0, because a number times 0 is equal to 0. Final result is equal to negative square root of 3. We have from fundamental formula of trigonometry. This is fundamental formula of trigonometry. Double angle formula. A double angle formula from this relation can be found by replacing this relation by making some transformation of this relation. From this relation, cosine square of x can be written as you see. Sine of x can be written. Sine of x sine of x can be written as the cosine square of x. Replace this one, its value. Cosine of 2x can be written as the cosine square of x negative sine square of 4 of x. Because we apply a relation of cosine of x, cosine of x plus x. Cosine of x plus x, when we apply the above relation of addition of cosine of x plus y, we get this relation. Here we can write sine of x plus x. It is the reason why here we have 2x. By using a relation of cosine of x plus x related to above formula of cosine of x plus y, by using that relation we get this one. So for the case of tan of 2x, by using a relation of x plus x in place of x plus y in above relation, we get the same result as here you see. By using also the value of cotangent of x plus y in that place, we replace x plus x, x plus x, then apply relation of cotan. You get the similar for values as cosine of cotan of x squared negative 1 over 2 cotan of x. We have example 1.4. Express cosine of 4x in a function of sine only. We have to express this one in a function of sine only. By using transformation formula of double angle, we can somehow find this value. As here you see, we have a cosine of 4x. We can divide this one into two values. It can be written as 2 times 2x. This is it stand for one values. This value can be, for example, related to y. Means cosine of 2y can be applied as cosine of 2y is equal to 1 negative 2 cosine square of y, for example. In place of y here, put 2x, because y is equal to 2x. Also in place of square x, you replace by 2x. Finally, you write 2 sine x cosine x square. Then, by applying this relation, you know this one, we are asked to find the value of cosine of x in a function of sine x only. So, for this case, after making a transformation of sine square of x, as here you see, transformation of this one above, sine x, you know sine of 2x is equal to 2 sine x times cosine of x. By replacing sine x with this way to x, you will get 2 2 times 2 sine x times the cosine of x. This is square here is this one. Then 1 negative 2, because 2, we raise 2 square as if we give 4 sine x square. They put square here on 2 and on sine and on cosine, we get this one. Then multiply 2 in this relation, we get 1 negative 8 sine square x cosine square x. Then from this relation, replace its equivalent. We get 1 negative 8 sine square x, factor of 1 negative sine square x. Because from fundamental formula of trigonometry of cosine square plus sine square equal to 1, sine square, cosine square only of x will give 1 negative sine square x. This is the reason why we replace cosine square of x with 1 negative sine square x. Then finally, this function is a function of sine only, as it is required in example. We have another example, double angle of formula. We have for the case of tangent, you are asked to find, given that we are given this value in the interval of pi 2, 3 pi over 2. We have to evaluate this one and evaluate this. So from this relation, you have square root of 2x. We know the value of sine. Sine is equal to opposite sine over hypotenuse. Cosine is equal to adjacent side over hypotenuse. Tan is equal to opposite side over adjacent side. From Pythagorean theorem, when we write this relation, as here you see, we have negative b plus b a negative b, and here we have square root of a square plus b square. Sine of 2x is equal to 2 sine x times cosine x. Means we have to replace sine x its value and cosine x its value, as it is somehow given from our relation. The result will be equal to 2 times negative a over square root of a square plus b square times negative b over square root of a square plus b square. Finally, the value of sine of 2x will be equal to 2 ax over a square plus b square. Because from the relation, you know a sine is equal to opposite side over hypotenuse. You know opposite side is equal to negative a, and hypotenuse is equal to square root of a square plus b square, the same as cosine. You know cosine of x is equal to adjacent side over hypotenuse, means adjacent side is equal to negative from our previous diagram, then over square root of a square plus b square. So by making some simplification and multiplication, final is equal to 2 AB over A square plus B square. For the case of tangent, you know, 2 times the tan of X over 1 negative tan square of X. You know the value of tan of X is equal to opposite side over adjacent side. It is the reason why is equal to A over B with a simplification of negative. As here you replace opposite side over adjacent side. Final result will be equal to 2 AB over B square negative A square. We have a half angle formula. Half angle formula from fundamental formula of trigonometry. You can raise this relation as sine of x over 2 is equal to plus or minus this relation, and cosine of x over 2 is equal to this relation. Then for the case of tan of x over 2, also we'll give this one, and the tan of x over 2 will give this one. So those formula are derived from fundamental formula of trigonometry, means sine of x square of x here over 2 and so on. Using a half formula to find exact value of cosine of 13, you know, half formula of cosine of 15 degrees. 15 degrees, when you write cosine of 15, is like to write a 30 over 2. 30 over 2 is a half angle of this relation. By applying a formula of cosine of x over 2, the result will be equal to square root of 1 plus cosine of 30 over 2. You know, value of cosine of 30 over 2 is equal to square root of 3 over 2 over then 2. Then square root of above, by making simplification, we will get the result as square root of 2 plus square root of 3 over 2. We have transformation formula. Transformation of or product in sum, we can make from product to sum relation. We have cosine of x times cosine of y is equal to 1 over 2 cosine of x plus y, then cosine of x negative 4 y. This is from multiplication to addition formula. For the case of sine x sine y is equal to cosine of x plus y negative cosine of x negative. The difference is here you have negative, here you have positive, here you have negative here. Sine of x times cosine of y. So you get sine with x plus y, sine of x negative y. For the case of cosine of x sine y, permutation of this one similar, except arranging the value of x and y. It's similar to this one, to above. Sine of x plus y, negative sine of x negative y. Transformation in sum, the product as here you see. You can write this relation in format of sum. Sine of 3x times cosine of 4x. By applying a relation of sine of y times cosine of y, sine of x times cosine of y, as here you see, we make substitution in relation we have. This one is equal to sine of 3x plus 4x plus sine of 3x negative 4x. Then this one gives 1 over 2 sine of 7x plus sine of negative x. Finally, we will get 1 over 2 sine of 7x negative sine of 4x. Those are the sum of this one. We have a formula for transforming sum into product. We use this relation. Those relations are from the previous one, but it's written as here you see. Cosine of P plus cosine of Q is equal to 2 cosine of P plus Q over 2. Cosine of P negative Q over 2. So here you have cosine of P negative 1. The difference is as here you have negative sine and here you have sine. For the case of sine P plus sine of Q, we have sine here, you have cosine, as you see. Sine of P negative sine of Q, the result, their product is equal to cosine of P plus Q and this sine of P negative Q. So you have somehow to know how to make transformation of this relation and know them simply. We have an example here. Transform in product the sum of this relation and this one. As we know, sum of x plus sine of y, the relation is this one. We have 3x plus 4x over 2 times cosine of 3x negative 4x over 2 by applying the above relation for the case of sine x plus sine of y. Final result, you know, you see, is a product of two trigonometric values. So this is the end. Mushobora no kudukurikira ku mbuga zikurikira aho musanga amasomo anyuranye. Ubu turi kwibanda ku masomo ya science n'imibare, math, set, physics, biology and chemistry, yo kuva primary P6 kugera kuri secondary S6. Udusure ukore na subscribe tubane igihe cyose. Izo mbuga ntizikurikira YouTube channel yitwa Think Big Twitter, website yacu Think Big Puerwa cyangwa se Iga Puerwa. Murakoze.